Hey, at your home, take an ice tray. Fill that with water. Then put that in a refrigerator. And then after few minutes or hours, what you get? Yes, we get a solid water. Or simply, we call it as an ice. So, on Earth, there are many places where you can find ice, like the North Pole and the South Pole. But now the question is that, can you find ice on the other planets in our solar system? Well, in short, the answer is yes. But keep watching this video to get some more detailed information about this topic. So, hey, what is up, people? This is Divyansh and welcome to my channel Learnium, where we learn and discuss with a lot of fun. Okay, so let us begin with Sun. Hey, no way to find ice there. So let's move this out and now let us begin with Mercury. But due to obvious reason that Mercury is the closest planet to Sun, you will probably answer that we cannot find ice here. But you are wrong. So basically, there are some very deep craters on the surface of Mercury and where the sunlight never reaches, and thus these regions always remain very cold. And also, NASA's Messenger mission saw some bright spots on the surface of Mercury, and scientists think that these bright spots are nothing but a solid water which are inside the very deep craters on the surface of Mercury. Okay, so after Mercury, let us bring Venus here. But the answer is no. There is no ice on the surface of Venus. So after that, it's time for the Earth. Well, I don't think that I have to explain about Earth, right? You know the answer. So now, let's directly bring the Mars. So there are some ice caps on the North and South Pole of the Mars. But during the winter season, near the poles, the carbon dioxide which is present in the atmosphere got freeze and falls on the surface of Mars. And for the proof, in 2017, NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter took some photos of the sand dunes on the Mars, and it found that these sand dunes, or the slope of these sand dunes, are covered with the solid carbon dioxide, or which we call it a dry ice on the Earth. Okay, so after the Mars, we have to directly jump on the Uranus and Neptune, because there is no ice in between. Now, these both beautiful planets contain some chemicals like methane, sulfur, and ammonia. And these both planets are the last two planets of our solar system. It means they are very far from the Sun. So, due to this reason, these chemicals got freeze into the crystals of ice. So it simply means that Neptune and Uranus has the ice of methane, sulfur, and ammonia. And due to this, these both planets are also called as ice giants. Okay, so with that, our planet journey is finished here. But for the fact, I want to talk about Pluto. Yes, NASA's satellites have actually found that Pluto is made up of frozen oxygen and nitrogen. Okay, so now let us talk about the moons. First, the Earth's moon. Well, the NASA's spacecraft such as Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter have found the evidence of water ice in the South Pole. And now, the three of the many other Jupiter's moon, which are like Europa, Callisto and Ganymede. So, these three moons of Jupiter's also have ice on their surface. And remember that ice does not mean to be only of water. The ice could be of other substance too. And now, talking about the Saturn's moon, then the Saturns have 60 moons and most of it have ice on their surface. Okay, so finally, at last, talking about the largest moon of Neptune. Yes, it is called Triton. And for the fact, this Triton moon is also the coldest object in our solar system. So, this moon also have ice on its surface and mainly the nitrogen ice. Okay, so I hope that you all gained some knowledge from this video, and if you did, then don't forget to hit the like button. And please do subscribe to my channel to watch more such informative videos. And now, thank you very much for watching.